Hi students, now we are watching 6th class mathematics unit 3 last video. So now I'm going to tell you the last topic, performing the arithmetic operations. What are the operations we have? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, right? These are the arithmetic operations we have. Okay, for example, I have an expression like this: 8 into 3 minus 4 divided by 2 plus 5. This problem I am going to calculate like this: 8 threes are 24 minus 4 divided by 2 plus 5. Now 24 minus 4, 20 divided by 2 plus 5. 20 divided by 2, 10 plus 5. What's the final answer? 15, right? Now, the same problem I'm going to do in the second way. 8 into 3 minus 4 divided by 2 plus 5. 8 3 is a 24 minus 4 divided by 2. Okay, let me do in the next step. 24 minus 4 divided by 2, 2 plus 5. 24 minus 2, 22 plus 5. 22 plus 5, 27. So, when I am doing from left to right, I got one answer. When I did 4 divided by 2 first, then subtraction next, I got another answer, right? Out of this, which is the correct answer? Which is the correct process? So we got it out. But the truth is, this is the correct answer. 15 is a wrong answer. Why? Why? Because we do have four different types of operations, arithmetic operations. Okay. But out of these operations, division is having the highest priority. Division is having the highest priority. After division, multiplication is having the second highest priority. Multiplication is having the second highest priority. Actually, you can also say as division and multiplication are having the same priority. And then addition. And at last, subtraction. Okay. Multiplication and division are having the first, addition and subtraction are having the second priority. See, now you understand, right? Division and multiplication are having the first highest priority. Addition and subtraction are having the second highest priority. See, I said these two are having the first highest priority. When you got situation with these two together, then do the division first. Okay. Now look at this problem. Here, 24 minus 4 divided by 2. I did 24 minus 4 first. That is the reason I got the wrong answer. Division is having the highest priority. So 4 divided by 2. The answer is 2. In this situation, I got the correct answer or not? Yes. So that is the reason you have to do division and multiplication first. Then after that, you can do addition and subtraction. Here, one subtraction and one addition is there. 24 minus 2 is 22 plus 5 is 27. 24 minus, if I do this one first, 2 plus 5, 7. One second. Sorry, dear. 5 minus 2, right? 5 minus 2 is 3. So 24 plus 3, 27. You got the same answer, right? So that is the reason I said addition and subtraction are having the second priority. Both are having the same priorities. 5 minus 2, 3, 24 plus 3, 27. In the same way, let us see one more example. 50 divided by 5 into 4. Okay. So, how to write this expression? So, If expression is looking like this, 50 by 5 into 4, here you can easily do like 5 ones, 5 tens, 10 fours are 40. But if they give expression like this, I already told you, if division and multiplication are together, first do the division first. So 50 divided by 5 means 10 into 4. The answer is 40 or not. Understand? If they give the expression like this, you can easily calculate. But if the expression is looking like this, you have to use the Bodmer's formula. First do the division. Sorry, you have to do the priority wise. First do the division, then multiplication. Okay. This is fine. But for example, we have a situation like this. See, Nandini made 100 laddus. There is a girl, her name is Nandini. She made 100 laddus, okay? And she kept 40 laddus to distribute them to her family. So, out of 100 laddus, she took off 40 laddus for the family members. And the remaining laddus were be distributed among their neighbors. And the remaining laddus are, she is going to distribute for neighbors. Neighbors means the people who stays near our house, next house, after house, before house, front house, like that. Okay, how many laddus will each of the neighbors get? Will each of her neighbors get? Is it 100 minus 40 divided by 3? So what they are saying is, there is a girl Nandini. She prepared how many laddus? 100 laddus. Out of 100, she kept 40 laddus for her family members. And remaining means 100 minus 40, 60, right? And remaining laddus, she distributed among her neighbors, three neighbors. So, divided by 3. How many laddus will each of the neighbors get? So, 3, 2's, 0. So each neighbor gets 20 laddus. When they ask the question, first of all, we have to write the expression. How we have to write 100 minus 40? First, total number of laddus. Then, the laddus which she take off for her family members. And after that, among all of them, she has to distribute